What's up guys, Sumer here at Train Life Fit, and we're gonna talk to you guys a bit about what mobility is versus flexibility. They're two very, very different things, and most people think they're the same. It just means you're flexible, you're stretching, okay? But let's start with flexibility. Flexibility is basically you being able to take a tissue, aka your muscle tissue, and stretching it to some end range. So for example, I can take my pec, right? And most all of us have seen this stretch before. You grab onto a doorway, you grab onto a rig, and then you just kind of turn your torso away and get this nice pec stretch that you feel over here. You're taking a muscle, you're stretching it to some end range. You feel good, you get done with it, oh, I feel kind of loose, right? Now the difference between that and mobility is that this is just stretching a tissue. Mobility is creating stability at the joint. Right? And we have to remember, movement happens at your joints. You think about that really simple concept. To move my shoulder, I have to be able to move at this joint over here. To move my hip, same thing, I move at my hip joint. And there are certain muscles that are having to contract or turn off or stabilize in order for you to move these different joints. Okay? So if you're gonna be mobile, you should be able to be stable throughout the entire range of motion you're trying to get to. Let's take, for example, overhead movements, where you're reaching your shoulder up overhead. Anyone can lift their arm up, but if you can do it with stability, AKA using certain muscle groups and moving your shoulder blade appropriately with the shoulder joint, or with the shoulder itself, then you're creating stability in the joint. That means you're more powerful, you're more stable, you're less prone to injury, and you can actually create more force over a longer range of motion. And that's really, really important. And that's way more beneficial to all of you rather than just flexibility. Because flexibility is just pretty short-lived. I can stretch for a couple seconds here, and I can go back to sitting on my computer like this, and guess what? I'm going right back to that same position that I don't want, this rounded kyphotic posture. But if you're training a pattern over and over, like a mobility pattern, okay, I wanna continually get my arms overhead, so I'm gonna do a bunch of these wall slides, I'm gonna do a bunch of like pull-aparts this way, or pull-aparts that way, or I'm gonna learn how to squat over and over with proper engagement, guess what, that pattern begins to stick, because your nervous system begins to run a program over and over and over. It's a neural program. So the more you can run those neural programs over and over, your body remembers what to do whenever you go into those positions. And that's very, very important. So you can even think about it this way. Flexibility is just stretching. Mobility is actually activating certain muscle groups while you go out through the entire range of motion. So if we can do a squat, a full range squat, going from here all the way down to here, I'm actually actively engaging my glutes, actively engaging my hamstrings, engaging my abs throughout the entire range of motion. I understand what's needed for the squat, I understand what's needed for the entire movement, and I'm actually performing the right engagements, the right kind of focus and breathing to do so. Okay, so that is the main distinction between both. So now that should give you a little bit of clarity whenever you go about your gym pursuits and you're thinking about improving some exercise, like a deadlift or a squat, or a push-up or a pull-up, just understand that sometimes the reason why you can't get enough force or enough power or the proper form is not just because you suck at something, it's simply because you don't have access to those muscle groups. Purely because maybe you're overly tight somewhere or don't have the mobility, and we know what mobility is, to do so. So you should pursue mobility of certain joints that are needed for that specific movement in order for you to succeed over and over in the gym. And be on the lookout for more of these videos. We're gonna talk about mobility for push-ups, for pull-ups, for deadlifts, for squats, the whole nine, okay? So more on this later. If you like this video, again, make sure you like the video, subscribe, and we'll talk to you next time, the next video. Peace.